Hey everyone, welcome to homeschool. So we are in the third part of the third chapter, that is plant kingdom. So we have already seen the introduction to the algae as well as one of the classes of the algae, that is chlorophyce, green algae we have completed. So in this video we will be starting with the next class, that is the brown algae, otherwise which is called as pheophyce. Chlorophyce, which we have completed, was called as green algae, and this pheophyce is called as the brown algae. So now we will see what are the characteristics of the brown algae now. So as we have seen the general characteristic of algae, most of them are marine. So definitely the pheophyce members are also majorly marine in nature. So the first characteristic is they are majorly marine organisms, or they are marine members. Then we said that these are brown algae, so definitely there should be presence of some pigments, isn't it? So which are the pigments which are present here? Is the first pigment is chlorophyll A, then chlorophyll C, then ENOIDS, carotenoids. All right, so chlorophyll A, chlorophyll C and carotenoids are the major pigments which are present in the brown algae. So these are the pigments, that is fine, but which is the pigment which is giving it the brown color? All right, the pigment which is making it look brown is the xanthophyll. Xanthophylls are the pigments which are present in the pheophyce, and among the xanthophyll, one particular pigment, that is fucoxanthin. Fucoxanthin is a pigment which is under the group of the xanthophylls, and this pigment is giving the brown color to the members of pheophyce. Fine. Then third characteristic is about the stored food. Stored food is in the form of a very complex carbohydrate which is called as laminarin or mannitol. It is in the form of complex carbohydrate. Complex carbohydrate, which is called as laminarin or mannitol. Laminarin or mannitol. So the stored food is in the form of the laminarin or mannitol in case of the pheophyce members. Then moving on to the cell wall. So how exactly the cell wall is? So here the cell wall is surrounded by one extra layer. Write it. Cell wall is surrounded by an extra layer, or a layer of a gelatin, by a gelatin layer which is called as algin. Okay, so if this is the organism, I'll just write it in a circular shaped cell. So around the cell wall there is one gelatinous layer, and this gelatinous layer is called as the algin layer. And the constituent of the algin, or what is algin made up of? The algin is made up of the alginic acid. Alright, the algin is made up of alginic acid. And what is the function of the alginic acid here, or the layer of algin here is, see, most of the members of the Phaeophyci, as I said, are marine. So definitely they will be encountering various waves there actually. So water currents will be there, water waves will be there, and those members of Phaeophyci have to encounter those water waves or water currents. So the function of the alginic acid is they protect or they give the strength to the members of Phaeophyci against the waves as well as the drying. So since the marine environment or the coastal areas are usually subjected to high temperatures, so definitely there is a chances that these members may dry up sometimes. So the presence of the gelatinous layer, which is made up of alginic acid and which is called as, the layer's name is the algin layer. Okay, that algin layer provides the protection to the Phaeophyci members against drying and the water waves. Alright, cell wall is surrounded by a gelatin layer which is called as algin. For your reference, let me write it here. Algin is made up of alginic acid. And what is the function of the alginic acid? It protects from drying and waves. It protects from drying and the waves. Then, how exactly the plant body is attached to the substratum? So, what is the substratum? For example, if you see some algal bodies which are being growing somewhere between the rocks or somewhere, so those will be fixed to a surface, isn't it? Those algae are not grown in the air. They are fixed to the substratum, or they are fixed to a particular surface and there they grow. So that surface is called as the substratum. So the algal body which is attached to a particular surface, that surface is called as the substratum. So here the plant body usually remains attached to a particular substratum with the help of one single cell or a part of the cell which is called as the holdfast. I'll just write one diagram here. See, this diagram is an example of the member of the Phaeophyci, that is the laminaria. Don't be confused with this word laminarin. Okay, laminarin is a stored food. It is a complex carbohydrate. And the diagram which I'm writing here is a member of the Phaeophyci, which is called as the laminaria. So, I'll write the diagram. So here, let's imagine we have some surface here. So this surface will be a substratum, and this Phaeophyci member, that is the laminaria, is attached to the substratum by a part of its body. This is its whole body. It is attached to the substratum by the part of its body which is called as the holdfast. So this is the holdfast. This is the substratum and this is the holdfast. Next one, this stalk-like structure which is an attachment for the holdfast as well as the frond, it is the stipe which in common terms can be called as the stalk of the organism or stalk of the laminaria. Fine. Then this upper surface which is giving the appearance of the leaf, right? Isn't it? It is looking like a leaf. So this structure which gives the appearance of the leaf is called as the frond. This is called as frond. So this is the front, this is the stipe, and this is the hold fast. By the hold fast, the brown algae will attach to the substratum. Then the function of the frond. So as I said, it is looking like a leaf. It is not only looking like the leaf, it is also functioning like a leaf. That is, this frond will carry out the photosynthesis. Frond majorly carries out the photosynthesis. So whereas the stipe, it is a connection between the frond and the holdfast, so that the plant or the body is properly erect. Fine. Then holdfast is mainly to get attached to the substratum here. And which is the example we are speaking about? This example is a laminaria. This example is laminaria. Okay, so the main characteristics are, these are majorly the marine organisms, and the pigments which are present here is chlorophyll A, chlorophyll C, carotenoids, and the xanthophylls. Among the xanthophyll, the predominant pigment which is present here is the fucoxanthin, which is actually giving the appearance of brown to the Phaeophyce members. Then stored food here in the Phaeophyce members is in the form of a complex carbohydrate, which is the laminarin, or it is also called as mannitol. Fine. Then moving on to the cell wall. Cell wall here is surrounded by one extra gelatinous sheath or a gelatinous layer, which is called as algin. Okay, that gelatinous layer name is algin, and that algin layer is made up of alginic acid. Fine. The function of the alginic acid here is to protect the members of Phaeophyce from drying as well as waves, water waves, because most of them are marine in nature, hence they have to be protected from the water waves. Then When you look into a complete body or complete structure of a Phaeophyce, these members have three parts. The first upper part is the frond, then the stipe, and the holdfast. And these members are not freely floating. Usually they get attached to a substratum. But you should also know that some members we sometimes can be seen as freely floating members also, but majorly they will be attached to the substratum. To attach to the substratum, it attaches by the hold fast. Okay, then frond, what is the function of the frond? These fronds are mainly photosynthetic, and for the photosynthesis we have the pigments chlorophyll A and chlorophyll C here for the photosynthesis, as well as the carotenoids. Fine. And then moving on to the reproduction part. Reproduction here, firstly we will speak about the vegetative reproduction. Vegetative reproduction, while speaking about the general characteristics of the algae, we have seen that majorly the vegetative reproduction is by the fragmentation only. So by this you already know what is fragmentation, because we have repeated fragmentation so many times. So fragmentation. Alright, then the asexual reproduction here. Asexual reproduction is mainly by the formation of the zoospores. Asexual reproduction, this is by the formation of the zoospores. And what you have to remember here is, these zoospores are majorly biflagellate. I'll write them. These are biflagellate zoospores. Biflagellate zoospores. So as the name suggests, these organisms or these spores are having two flagellas. All right, but what exactly you have to remember about these biflagellate here is those both flagellas are not the similar kind of flagellas here. So usually what happens in case of the biflagellates, so both the flagella will be same, or probably the sizes may vary in some cases. But in this Phaeophysi members, what is happening here is these biflagellate zoospores are having two different types of flagella. Okay, they're having two different types of flagellas. So I will just draw a diagram of the zoospore here. So let's imagine this is one spore. Okay, this is one spore, and we have one first flagella . This is somewhat called as at the base it is quite thick, and then it tapers like this. Okay, so here at the base it is quite thick, and then it slightly tapers like this. It tapers like this. Fine. So this kind of flagella is called as the whiplash flagella. All right. This flagella, this is the first type of flagella in the zoospore. Out of the biflagellate, that is two flagellas, the first type of flagella is the whiplash flagella. That is, towards the base, it is quite thick. Okay, and then as in it moves further, it starts tapering, and that is called as the whiplash flagella. Then another type of flagella here is the second type of flagella. So this has some bristles like this. This is called as tinsel flagella, and this is called as whiplash flagella. So the first flagella is the whiplash flagella, second flagella is the tinsel flagella, and these small outgrowths, okay, these small outgrowths, these are called as bristles. These are called as bristles. So these are the two types of the flagellas which are present in the asexual zoospores of the Phaeophysi members. Then how about the sexual reproduction? Sexual reproduction, it is again by the fusion of the gametes. fusion of gametes, and the fusion of gametes can be isogamous, it can be anisogamous, or it can be oogamous also. So we already have seen what is iso, what is aniso, and what is oogamous. So isogamous, in case of isogamous, two gametes which are fusing here, that is a male gamete and a female gamete, these two gametes are similar. All right, if two similar gametes are fusing, then we call it as the isogamous. Iso is similar, and gamous is gametes. Okay, anisogamous is two dissimilar gametes getting fused, is called as the anisogamous. And how about the oogamous? In case of oogamous, one gamete is large and non-motile. So the one which is large and non-motile is usually a female gamete, and the one which is motile and small is a male gamete. So these two gametes will fuse in case of the oogamous. So here one is motile and small, which is a male gamete, and another one is non-motile and it is larger in size, that is the female gamete. These two gametes fuse to form the oogamous type of the sexual reproduction. Okay, so this is about the Phaeophysi or brown algae. Fine. So I hope it is clear. And next we will move on to the rhodophysi, or otherwise which is called as the red algae. The members of rhodophysi are called as red algae. The reason behind this is it is due to the presence of a predominant pigment called as phycoerythrin. Rhodophysi members have a pigment called as phycoerythrin. Usually we write it as R phycoerythrin. So due to the presence of this pigment, these algae are usually, or they appear red in color. Okay, so R phycoerythrin is the predominant pigment which is present in the members of rhodophysi. And then other characteristics of the rhodophysi members is these are marine, and usually they are in the warmer areas of the marine environment. These are also majorly marine, and in that marine environment, the warmer areas are preferred by the members of rhodophysi. In the warmer areas. Next one, these are present in both the areas where the light reaches as well as in the areas where the light doesn't reach in the ocean. That is, they are present in both light and darker areas of oceans. So why this particular point is important here is because, see, we know that algae are mostly photosynthetic in nature, isn't it? And to perform the photosynthesis, sunlight is necessary. And in the darker, if this is the bottom of the ocean, so till the bottom of the ocean, the sunlight doesn't penetrate, isn't it? So sunlight penetrates up to only a particular, if this is the topper part of the, this is the surface of the ocean, this is the bottom of the ocean, probably up to some extent the sun rays can penetrate. So at the areas of the bottom area, sun rays cannot penetrate. So if the organisms which are present here usually are non-photosynthetic because there is no sunlight and they cannot perform photosynthesis. But we know that algal forms are mostly photosynthetic in nature, so definitely they should be present in these areas. Almost all the types of algae, whether it is green algae, brown algae, red algae is quite an exception because it is present here as well as here. Okay, whereas in case of Phaeophysi and as well as Chlorophysi, they are majorly present in this area because they have to perform photosynthesis. Even these organisms also should perform photosynthesis, but as an exception, we find a few Rhodophysi members in the darker regions of the oceans also. Okay, and then moving on, speaking about the thallus here. So the thallus is strictly multicellular. Thalli or the thallus is multicellular. It is multicellular. Then, how about the stored food? In case of the Phaeophysi, we had seen the stored food was in the form of a complex carbohydrate called as laminarin or the mannitol, isn't it? In case of the Rhodophysi members, the stored food is usually in the form of the Floridian starch. Floridian starch is the stored food. Floridian starch is the stored food, and this Floridian starch is almost similar to the structures of the amylopectin and the glycogen. This Floridian starch is also a complex carbohydrate, or it is a polysaccharide. Fine, it is a polysaccharide or a complex carbohydrate, and this is similar to the amylopectin and glycogen in structure. I'll write it. It is similar to the amylopectin and glycogen in the structures. Okay, then moving on to the cell wall. What exactly is the cell wall of the rhodophyceae members made up of? The cell wall here is made up of cellulose, pectin and sulfate. Cell wall is made up of cellulose, pectin and sulfate. It is made up of cellulose, pectin and sulfate. Okay. And to quote a few examples of the members of the rhodophyceae, is the best example is a jellidium. Example is jellidium. Okay, another example here to quote for the red algae or the rhodophyceae is the porphyrum. Okay, see, jellidium, we had already discussed this jellidium in the general characteristics. While seeing the general characteristics of algae, there we had seen this jellidium already. So one more example is porphyrum. It is porphyrum. Okay, so moving on to the reproduction part of the red algae. So reproduction, as usual, again the vegetative reproduction is by fragmentation. Vegetative reproduction is by fragmentation. And then how about the asexual reproduction? The asexual reproduction is by the non-motile spore formations. Okay, it is by non-motile spores. Then sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction here is mostly oogamous in nature. It is mostly oogamous. What is oogamous? Oogamous is here the female and male are different as well. The male is small and motile. The female is large and non-motile. So that such kind of sexual reproduction are called as oogamous type of sexual reproduction. Or that such a fusion of such kind of gametes is called as a oogamous or oogamy. Fine. So one thing which you have to observe here is most of the spores are non-motile only. It means that most of them are not having flagella. Alright, so in the previous case, in case of brown algae, we had seen that biflagellate members, tinsel type of flagella, whiplash type of flagella and all. So here, what you have to notice here is most of them doesn't have flagella at all because they are non-motile, they are having non-motile spores. So most of them doesn't have flagella here. Okay, so these are the characteristics of the red algae. We will quickly revise it once. Phycoerythrin is the predominant pigment which is making the algal body appear red in color. Then these are majorly marine. They are present in the areas where the light penetrates as well as the areas where the light doesn't reach in the parts of the ocean. And this thallus is usually multicellular in nature. And the stored food in case of rhodophyceae is Floridian starch, which is almost similar to the amylopectin and the glycogen in the structure. Fine. Cell wall, it is made up of cellulose, pectin and sulfide. Then the examples are jellidium and porphyra. Moving on to the reproduction, vegetative reproduction is by the fragmentation. Asexual reproduction is by the formation of non-motile spores and the sexual reproduction here is majorly oogamous in nature. Clear? Okay, so we have completed the algae here. So all the classes of algae, that is chlorophyceae, pheophyceae and rhodophyceae. So in the next part of the video, we will come up with the bryophyta. Okay, so all the general characteristics of the bryophyta as well as the what are the groups which comes under the bryophyta, we will see it in the next part. So subscribe the channel and study hard for the examinations.